Welcome to KCTK Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew and Jack all up in your face. Join in on the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We dare you.
And welcome to KCTK's Radio's Week Review with Paul and Drew. I'm Jack, that's Drew. This is the show where we talk about things from last week and things that may happen next week. You can join the experiment by calling or texting us at 913-735-0060. We welcome your participation. We broadcast live every Thursday night at 7 p.m. As you know, you can listen to us live streaming at kctk.radio12345.com. But it's easier to use the Listen to My Radio app on your phone that you can get on the Apple Store or Google Play. Once you get to the app, just search for KCTK. It's that easy. Also, you can watch all the action live on YouTube or a KCTK radio channel, or watch past episodes whenever you want there. But that's not all. This program is also offered as a podcast on iTunes, Podbean, or anywhere where you get your favorite podcasts. Hello, CurMutt.
Yeah, this is CurMutt. A.K.A. Little Bow Wow. A.K.A. Drewfaw.
Yeah.
And we're to the homies. Work. Chelsea and Ace.
Oh, how are you doing, CurMutt?
I'm okay and everything like that.
Okay, how's your week been?
I'm a little nervous and everything.
Okay. Well, we will get back to you here in a second, okay?
Okay.
And now, for the reason that everybody's here, Drew.
What's going on, ladies and gentlemen? It's the Drew Shake, a.k.a. You guys ruined it.
You're not going to finish.
Sorry about
no,
that.
I'll finish it. Oh. Okay. a.k.a. Pancho Villa, a.k.a. LL Cool J.
I don't understand what any of those mean, but okay.
I don't get it.
Mama said knock you out, and I'm about to.
Okay. obviously, we have a little bit of change of scenery here.
Yes, Paul, it is his birthday. And I also want to give a shout out to his twin brother,
Steve.
Happy birthday, Steve.
Happy birthday.
And we have a special guest, CurMutt, who you've already listened to.
I'm here every time, so.
Oh.
Yeah, he's here every time. But obviously, as you guys can tell, Paul's not here. He's on his birthday extravaganza.
I hear he's on a cruise.
I hear he's on a cruise, too. I don't know how he's able to afford
I don't know
that.
Why he even bother going on a cruise.
I think it was part of his bonus that
I
Matt
understand
gave him.
And maybe, hopefully he's not wearing them flip-flops because he's got some gnarly feet. Let me tell you.
They're called Chacos.
Oh, thongs. Right. Gotcha. Thongs.
Yeah. So we're kind of switching it up a little bit today.
Yeah, absolutely.
Obviously, without him, we got this.
We're going to do this. We're going to make this happen. This is just like the time when the Druge lost his voice and was not here.
Exactly.
And they were able to still survive. And I'm talking about they as in Paul and Jack.
Now, we could go on all day talking about this stuff.
Right.
About how Paul's not here. I was having a great time in the Bahamas or Alaska, wherever he is. But really, nobody really cares about all that.
Yeah, I understand completely.
There's one thing that people come here for, and that is news from the Druge.
That's fair. So, here's the deal. I'm going to switch it up a little bit in the first one, because I'm going to tell you all about my job search, how that's been going, all right? So, I had an interview Monday. First time anybody's given me an interview. And I'm going to be honest with you, it just didn't feel right.
I had
a gut feeling.
Where was it at?
I'm going to go ahead and say the name. It's called Excel Inc.
Is this like a printing company?
No, it's a marketing firm. Ooh. They claim to be a marketing firm. So here's the deal.
Oh, yes.
Me and my wife, I get a call from them. I'm like, absolutely, I'll come in on 9:30, come in for my interview. Absolutely, I'm gonna get my suit all ironed and looking all nice. And so my wife decides to look up this place and shatter this dream that I'm thinking I'm going to get a job. And the mixed reviews, there's a lot of mixed reviews on this place. Like, one person called it a pyramid scheme. One person said that they work you to the bone and you work from like 7 to 9 in p.m. every day. And you get paid $10 an hour. No, that's not how that's going to go. Not with this guy.
So, wait, did you know about this information that you gathered, did you
know this prior to the interview or after?
I knew it prior to the interview.
Okay, cool. Yeah. So you still went to the interview, right?
Right. So I, instead of using the interview as trying to get a job, I used it as a way of practicing for an interview. So.
Okay, okay. And how did it go?
Okay, so here it is. I walk in. I ended up being late because it's in Lenexa, and I got stuck in traffic, and they closed down this one part.
First step for getting better for an interview. Don't be late.
So far, we hit some places. Okay, so I show up. I'm in my suit. I'm looking great. I walk in, and there's a secretary who I realized was the woman I talked to on the phone, and I thought I talked to somebody from HR. Guess not. They have Blair and Selena Gomez. They have this little boombox in the corner just blaring all over the place.
High quality. That's
a
nice place.
So I'm looking around the place and everything, and there are five offices that are fucking empty. Oh. There are nobody in these offices. Maybe a chair. That's it.
No desk?
No desk. So I noticed that there's a secretary, and there's one door closed, and I can hear people talking in there. So I'm thinking maybe they're having like a meeting or something. Cool. So I'm waiting out there, you know, I fill out my application and everything, hand it back, and a guy comes out, I guess there was another interview, so they didn't even know I was late, so that, even better. Walk in, the woman has an aggressive handshake and eye contact, like holy hell.
Like, what does she look like? Not,
she's pretty. So
you're like, please shake my hand.
I was like, cool with it. So I sit down, I go into the interview. And she's like, here, just go ahead and have a seat. Well, I feel like my pants are bunching, so I'm like kind of pulling at it. And I realized that I got caught doing it. So this nervousness.
You're picking your butt and everything like that?
Right. That's absolutely correct, CurMutt. And I realized that I need to like stop doing what I'm doing, so I just sat down immediately. So after that, everything was going smoothly. She's marking up my resume that my uncle helped me make. And I explained myself. She's like, how much do you want? And I was like, about 30K a year is what I'm looking for, salary, for art director. And she's like, okay, well, we'll let you know if you get a second interview, or we'll let you know that if we're going to take a different direction by the end of the day. I'm like, cool. I sat down for 10 minutes. I'm not fucking with you. The interview lasted 10 minutes. And I have a feeling that it didn't go well in the first place. I think 30K may have just shied her off. But it just felt weird. Apparently, you were going to sell products online, and it's a pyramid scheme. That's the best way I could describe it. So, yeah, I walked out, never heard anything back, didn't get any confirmation or anything.
When was this?
This was yesterday.
Well, what if they're still deciding? What if your phone rings in 10 minutes?
Then I'm probably going to turn it down. $10 an hour, I get paid $1 more than that at my work. Like, what's the point?
Fair enough.
So, yeah, my first interview.
Yeah, that
in
was 10 great.
Years, so good times.
Well, you know, it was a short interview, but at least it was an experience for you.
Right.
Of course. Okay. Yeah. Well, thank you for sharing.
No problem. I'm going to keep everybody updated if I ever get another one, but I'm hoping for this other job I'm looking at.
Okay. Sweet.
Yep.
Okay, now for the real thing people come here for. We have tech news with CurMutt.
Oh, switching it up today. I like it.
I know. I'm
digging it.
I'm normally doing it, but
hot dog.
Yeah. Yeah, I've done the tech news and everything like that. This is pretty cool and everything because there was this guy one time, and he his name's Jeff Bebos, and he has a robot dog, and he took it around and He was at this thing and he had a robot dog and it's pretty cool. And I think anything that's like a fake dog is pretty cool and everything like that.
Wow. Are you saying Jeff Bezos, the CEO of Amazon, had a robot dog?
Yeah.
I'm going to look this up.
You know, also a fun little fact for you, CurMutt. He might also be buying all the Toys R Us chains.
Really?
Yeah.
He had a dog. He's like, here, boy, and everything, come here. And then the dog, you know what the dog did?
What did it do?
What did the dog do? Did it take a piss?
No, I went and followed him and everything like that. Because well, he was a dog.
That is so interesting, CurMutt. Maybe, do you have anything else you want to add to that? Was the dog, like, did it have a head and everything? Because I have seen the robot deers and they have no head.
Here it is, the dog. He's like, here, boy. Okay, I'll come
That's
after you.
The creepiest looking thing I've ever seen.
Oh, it has a voice and everything. Oh, here, boy.
Is this like BB, prototype BB-8's following him? Star Wars reference.
I think yeah, I like it.
I think it's a Cocker Spaniel.
You know, for... It's got some weird legs.
You know, it looks more like a Great Dane. I don't know about Cocker Spaniel.
It's pretty cool, and everyone... Like, you may have a made-up dog. It's pretty cool. Whenever you do that.
It looks adorably creepy.
I wonder
creepy.
If it's one of those things that you can, like, put, kick over.
And that's tech news with CurMutt!
Thank you, CurMutt.
Okay. Thank you for joining us for the first part of KCTK, but we are now going to take a break. So, thank you, and we'll be back here in a minute. Bye. And we're going for a break here in a second. Don't worry, the break will come here soon. Don't worry, it's coming.
Is it?
Yeah, I don't know if it is or not. This music is still going on. It's not stopping.
Okay, the nervous talking.
Okay. Okay, yeah, now we're going on a break. Sorry. I thought we were going on a break before, but now we're going on a break.
Oh, man.
Sorry.
Flying solo with you is just going to be a trip.
Hold on, dude. This is my first time doing it.
All right, let's pop that chair. It's going to be a gentle process, I promise you. It'll hurt first, but then eventually it's just going to feel good.
At least you'll be a virgin for longer than I will.
That's absolutely correct.
And we'll be right back.
Ice cream, we make people happy.
It's so delicious.
Baskin Robbins ice cream.
We make kids happy,
grown-ups happy. Makes a fun party for everyone.
We love it.
You love it. World's best ice cream. We make people happy. Baskin Robbins ice cream. We make people happy
at Baskin Robbins.
Baskin Robbins ice cream.
Shut up and sit down.
What's going on, guys? This is Johnny with Bubble Cup Cheese Zone. Yes, right. We're going to have ourselves a great time. It's all about bubble tea. That's right. Carbonated with bubbles and tea. Carbonated tea. It's going to be awesome, y'all. You just come on down to Bubble Cup Tea Zone in Columbia, and you just get yourself a nice bubble cup tea. Let me tell you. It comes in peach, black tea, Earl Grey, oolong, mango, sweet tea, and many others. Let me tell you, just come on down to the Bubble Cup Key Zone in Columbia, Missouri, and ask for Johnny.
Sunday. Yeah. The season's first championship meet from Pasadena, California. The world's champion, Don Nicholson. Mr. Stock Eliminator himself. Driving his 1962 409 horsepower Impala Super Super Stock. And his 1962 Chevy 2 powered by a 360 horsepower fuel-injected Corvette engine. Running in the new factory experimental class. Coming all the way from Pasadena, California to defend his world championship title. In wheel-to-wheel battle with Detroit's own Ram Chargers 410 horsepower Dodge Dart. Plus Dragsters, Connie Coletta, Double Trouble, Anderson. Extra this Sunday. Free copies of Car Life magazine at Detroit Dragway.
Sibley at Dix. Take Telegraph to Sibley. Drive 1 mile east to Dix. Racing begins at 2 p.m.
Sunday.
Sunday at the Detroit Dragway.
Yeah, Yeah, this is CurMutt and everything. Like, I was told to tell you that this portion of the week review is brought to you by Andy's Hickory Pit and Pub in Eldon, Missouri. I think you had to go there and everything and get some stuff, but make sure you get a doggy bag, because, like, you should bring bones home. Like, if you get any bone, you should take the bones home to your dogs, because they like to eat on those and stuff. And then you also should maybe get them, like, a little sandwich and stuff, because they have doggy bags. And Andy's has doggy bags, and you should get them, because that's pretty cool and everything like that.
In Eldon, Missouri.
And we are back.
Excuse me, are you me?
No, but I wanted to at least do it once.
And we're back. We're back. We're here again. Kermit, how you feeling so far?
You guys didn't like my live read and everything like that, but I'm going to get a bone and stuff like that.
It was great.
I just remember there was a video once that Paul sent me of Gilly eating a bone. It was hilarious and cute.
Do you have a bone?
I don't have one. Sorry, bud. I'll get you a treat later. We got it.
Okay, yeah. sorry about Ace and everything like that.
Yeah, you're good.
It's a sad day.
You're good. Okay,
it's a sad week.
Everybody. One of our most popular segments on the show. And I'm really sad that Paul can't be here to partake in this. But it's commercial reviews. How do you feel about commercial reviews?
I absolutely enjoy thrashing them and trashing them.
That was a good rhyme.
Yeah, you like
it's
that?
It's actually my favorite part of the whole entire show.
Thrashing and trashing?
Oh, yes, yeah.
Exactly.
Cool.
God, you get it.
And crashing.
Hank.
Add another one.
Hell yeah!
Fuck yeah! Woo!
Okay, now we do have a first commercial. It is an icebreaker commercial. You know Icebreaker the gum?
Oh, Dentine Ice?
Exactly.
Dentine Ice.
So apparently their marketing team has just done something crazy. And we're actually going to watch it here. Kermit, if you would please press play.
Justin. Nothing. What you doing?
Hey.
What?
Okay.
What?
So just for a little clarification for the viewers, it is two girls sitting at a bus stop. Okay.
Right.
And one of them not very attractive.
There's another dog and everything.
There's not another dog.
I thought that was a dog.
Okay. She looks like a dog.
Neither of these women are attractive.
Neither of them are attractive. But the worst looking one gets a text on her phone saying from Justin. Do you know Justin?
No, I don't know Justin.
I don't know Justin either.
Justin and me do not know each other, and there's a reason why.
And it says, what you doing? So.
What does she do?
What does she do? Click play on the commercial.
Kermut.
Justin.
Oh, no.
Oh, Justin.
Don't worry, though. She's got an icebreaker. Boom! And she's riding a unicorn.
Now, pause it again real quick. She crashes through this man's living room.
With a unicorn.
An ice unicorn, let me go in and say this. Through his TV, through his wall, and holds up her phone and says, nothing, what are you doing?
Here's my thing, okay? It's just like the Kool-Aid commercials all over again. The dude comes in, destroys your house, having a good time drinking Kool-Aid.
Yeah, but the Kool-Aid commercials
are cool. Oh, yeah! Like, no, why don't you fix the hole in the wall? Like, come on, man.
The Kool-Aid commercials are cool. You're just basically comparing this trash to something classic.
That guy is not getting his security deposit back.
Dude, that dude's pissed. He sits there and goes, why is this unattractive girl coming in here?
With a unicorn.
I think it should be riding a dog.
I agree.
About a robot dog?
That'd be pretty cool. That makes sense.
A Great Dane.
So it wouldn't happen. That half good looking dude would not be talking to that dumpster of a woman. Boing.
I disagree with that and everything, just for the record. Okay.
I
speak on behalf of the management and proprietors of KTK.
Not to mention the fact she destroyed his television.
Exactly.
That's a $3,000 television,
honestly,
I'm sure.
Honestly, that's a big wall with a 32-inch TV
on
it.
She could easily be sued for doing something like this. Look at me. I'm on a unicorn.
So
stupid.
Yeah, it was very short. It's 15 seconds long. It's nothing too grand. What would you give this commercial?
I give it a zero.
You don't even know what the scale is. Okay,
it's
zero.
It's 1 to 5.
No, it's 1 to 10.
Oh, my God. So zero.
I give it a 1.
You're too generous.
I give it a 5 because it has an animal in it, which I like. And then it should be a 5 because it's not a dog.
Well, all right. We're moving on. What's the next one? What do we got the next one as?
It's a Schick Razors commercial.
Dude, watch your mouth. Okay? I don't like that language.
I'm sorry.
Don't you be saying Schick.
It's a Schick
That's
razor.
That's a lot of Schick coming out of your mouth.
It's a Schick razor commercial.
I don't like that Schick.
You know what Schick does? They're the company that make razor blades.
Oh!
Razor blades!
I have a beard, so I don't shave.
You have a beard.
I don't believe in it.
So, it's 30 seconds, so it's not too long of a commercial. Roll it. So, this dude's been partying.
Extreme 3 by Wilkinson. All right.
Oh my God. He's shaving in the car.
Which is
not
very
good.
Dangerous. The dude can easily
up.
Cut himself.
Exactly. He's woken up from a party, and he goes, damn, I got to get somewhere to go.
Gots to go.
The Schick razors just happen to be sitting in this guy's hallway.
Again, with the language. Schick? God, this guy.
I know. We'll add it to the dictionary.
Don't be
it's
adding
okay,
the Schick
saying.
On this Schick, all right?
Okay. And then he gets in this taxi, and he starts shaving in the car. He didn't even grab shaving cream, but he happens to have it on his face. He happens to have it on his
Don't
face.
Don't worry, he got soap or something, then he just added to it.
Exactly. So now he's sitting here shaving in the car. No water.
I mean, it's okay.
Any contour for optimum comfort.
They bumped, and he hasn't even cut himself. Twist. He's, honestly, he looks pretty good.
Oh, yeah?
He's looking at himself in the mirror. After a clean shave.
You didn't know that taxi cabs have a shaving cream dispenser inside of it?
I didn't know that. I didn't know that was a thing.
Oh, it's a thing.
So now he's gone to his destination.
Honestly, he does look pretty good.
He's now looking himself in the mirror, and he's ready to go.
Not to mention the fact that he smells like...
Oh,
but don't worry.
The punchline. They're a shave... Whenever you shave in a car, you get a smiley face on your head.
No, because I'm thinking his friends did that to him for his party, when he was at the party.
Oh, that makes more sense.
Yeah.
I didn't I didn't come to that conclusion. That's why the razor blades were sitting out.
Well, wait till you see the ending of it. Have you seen the ending of this one?
I have not.
I have. Extreme 3. He's bald! He had a razor blade able to cut his entire hair off.
Oh wait, he was going to his wedding this whole time.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, they have female ones too.
Oh, good.
They have ones for the
females.
I gotta
make sure to get my ankles.
Wakes up. Puts on
pants.
Oh
my God! I'm getting married today.
Oh my God.
3 flexible blades that uniquely adapt to any contour for optimum comfort.
Optimum comfort.
For any twist. Or turn, life hands you.
So what are they called? Groomsmen?
Yeah.
When they laugh at him, they're inside, but then they automatically appear outside,
right.
And then they
Here,
walk
I
in.
I want to make this abundantly clear. My friends ever did that to me after my bachelor party or something, I punched them square in their face.
Every single one of them?
Every single one of them. Hmm. All 7.
All 7.
All 7 gotten their asses kicked.
Damn. Okay.
One of them probably could have... maybe 2 could probably take me. It's all good.
Maybe 2.
All right, all 7 could have taken me. Whatever.
I'll give this commercial 2.
I give it a...
1. Take it back, 1.
I'm going to give it a 1 because there's not any animals and everything like that.
People are technically animals.
Oh, okay. I'll give it a 5.
Oh, good. So you gave it the max number 5.
Max
Fantastic.
Number 5.
I
okay.
love it.
Now, we have one more commercial. Would you consider a trailer a commercial?
Yes, I do.
Okay, we have one more commercial.
Because we're putting it on.
It actually came out today.
Yeah.
It's the Deadpool 2 trailer.
Absolutely.
DP2. There have been other trailers, but this is like the first official trailer.
Yay! Hercules!
And we're just going to go and watch it, and Drew's going to nerd out over it, because that's what he does with superhero stuff.
Absolutely, I do.
Absolutely, he will. Okay, let's go ahead and watch it. Kermit, could you please move your mouse?
Deadpool running down an alley. And Swan dives into the car.
I love Swally. I think that's what his name is.
Dopender.
Yeah, that's right. Dopender.
Slice.
Kicking ahead aside.
On heels. Slicing people up.
Sorry I'm late. I was rounding up all the gluten
in the world.
Launching in space where it can't not hurt us ever again.
Kiss me like you miss me, Red.
Mm.
How about
that?
That
chick is so hot.
She is. She's in Gotham.
Yeah.
What in the fucksicle is this?
Yeah.
It's Cable. I'm here for the kid.
You know the guy who plays Cable is the guy who plays Thanos.
Yeah. Move or die. His name is Josh Brolin.
Mr. Brolin is double the Marvel.
He's also Barbara Streisand's son.
Yeah.
Kids give us a chance to be better than we used to be. He needs you.
You're a lot
smarter than I look.
I ain't letting Cable kill this kid.
The kid shoots up two middle fingers. That's fun.
It's hard to hear you with that pity dick in your mouth.
We're gonna form a super duper fucking group. Meet them tough, morally flexible, and young enough to carry their own franchise for 10 to 12 years.
Yeah.
X-Force.
Is X-Force a real thing?
Yeah.
Is Deadpool on X-Force?
I don't remember exactly. He's usually just by himself, but I think they're doing this on purpose.
Maybe he'll make it and leave it.
Yeah.
He'll be like, I hate this.
Yeah.
Tell me they got that in slow motion.
Doing the right thing is messy. But if you want to fight for what's right...
I'm so ready for Negasonic Teenage Warhead again. She's so hot.
Yeah, she is. She's the only chick I've ever seen that pulls off a shaved head easily.
Pornography. Oh, God, I wish I finished college.
DP2.
It lives up to the hype, plus plus.
Fuck it, they probably won't even make a 3.
Yeah, why would they? Stop at 2. You killed it.
Oh, I love it. I hope they do a third one.
What is your thoughts on this, Drew?
I can't wait. It looks as good as the first one. First one was hilarious.
Kermit?
Is Crypto in it?
Crypto is actually a DC character.
No. I like they have a dog in it and everything.
Well, there's not.
Well, there is not. So.
Sorry, bud.
It's a nice try.
Did they ever do a thing called Dog Man?
No. You understand that not everything has to have a dog in it, correct?
Fuck you.
Maybe you should start reading Garfield's Pet Force if you really want to do something like that, all right?
That's actually really good.
I know, I love that. I used to buy those books.
They were good
times.
Yeah.
So that is our commercial review.
Yep. What would you give that on a rating? 1 to 10.
I give it a 10.
I give it a 10. I give it a 9 because there's still a little bit of mystery in there for me.
Right.
9.
Okay.
All
okay. Right.
Kermit, do you have a rating?
I give it a 7, but that's 1. That's a 1 in people use.
A
little dog humor there. I like that.
A little dog humor. Okay.
I like it.
These are good. It was a good round.
It was a good round.
It was
also a little pitiful.
I'm really missing Paul.
I do. I miss Paul, too. I kind of do.
Yeah.
And he's out there just hanging out in the Caribbean, dick. Or, you know, hanging out in Portugal. I don't know where he's at.
Who knows? We're going to go and take another break. Okay? From stopping you from going on a tangent. Okay. We'll be right back.
Until I saw the cover girl in my favorite magazine. Her cover girl complexion really gave me such a shake up, cause it looks so fresh and natural. Who'd believe it's makeup, but it's new cover girl makeup by Noxzema. New medicated makeup by Noxzema.
Covers blemishes so completely they just seem to disappear. And while you conceal them, you even help heal them since CoverGirl is here.
First use the liquid, what a difference it will make. Your skin looks creamy smooth all day and it doesn't peel or flake. New CoverGirl powder is the antiseptic stuff.
Help purify your skin each time, cause it fights germs on your puff.
So get a CoverGirl complexion to give the boy.
boys a shake up. Get new Cover Girl by Noxzema, the medicated makeup.
Hi, my name's Hank. And I was on the Gary Stewartson show till I got, you know, killed off. But now I guess I'm having to try to pay the bills. So here's the deal. Are you fucking kidding me? All right. Well, there's this place called Dryer Shoes. They have the same thing called Wet Shoes. Is this for real? Are we really doing this right now? Dryer Shoes? You could have thought of something better than that. Anywho, Dryer Shoes, they can, you know, fix your shoes, make sure they're dry. And they also do, they also take out ink stains, and this is a laundromat. Okay, well, you know, that's what it is. So, my name's Hank. Why don't you go ahead and check me out at Broadway? I'm going to be on Broadway now because I'm not in the Gary Stewartson show anymore. Thanks for killing me off, guys. It's bull. Anyway, check out Dryer Shoes in Columbia, Missouri.
You hate it, don't you?
Oh, no, it's delicious. What is it?
Beef stroganoff. I learned to make it in home ec.
Yeah, great. Got anything to drink?
Pepsi?
Fine. What do you call this green stuff?
Mashed potatoes. I guess it really isn't too good, is it?
Oh, no. It's terrific.
Jerry, why are you lying to me?
Oh, I'm not lying to you. Well, maybe a little.
Don't you like anything?
Yeah. The cook.
You belong, cause you've got a lot to live, and Pepsi's got a lot to give. Yeah, Pepsi's got a lot to give.
Everyone should go to Buffalo Wild Wings, cause like, they have this patio. And you can bring your dog and be outside and everything. But also, don't give dogs chicken wings because it goes into their throat and makes them die and everything like that. And you should go to Buffalo Wild Wings. It's in Columbia. And Megan and Crystal will probably be there and say hello to you because they go there every week. And they have a good time. And I love chicken. And go to Buffalo Wild Wings, but don't give your dog any of the bones because I don't want them to die and stuff.
And we're back.
Welcome back, Drew.
Hey, what's going on? We got Gilly, Kermut's girlfriend, in the building.
Whoa.
She is missing Paul.
Yeah, she is.
She looks distraught.
Okay, so we have this segment every week.
Right.
It's listener's request.
I can show you a pond.
But before that, we have Gilly in the studio today. Come here, Gilly.
Tell any friends when you last
seen.
Come here.
Oh, never mind. She doesn't want to
talk. She doesn't want to be on the show.
She's around.
You're not Paul.
You're Paul.
Never mind. I can't touch them. He moves away when I rub them. Yeah, he thinks he's better than me.
What do you think of the mic?
A standard
mug. I have Gilly in my hands right
now. A pudgy, flabby mass of skin. Just look at his stomach. An endless pit. And then he's back to napping. The standard mug. There's no such
look
thing
at your
as privacy.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, Gilly.
Thank you, Gilly.
Anyway, back to the show.
Back to the show. This is the listener's request. Girls just want to have fun on KCTK Radio.
Oh, girls.
girls just want to have fun.
And this one goes out to Drew. Actually, sorry, Quinn. Goes out to Quinn. So she can have fun in her life. Oh, Quinn. I'm so excited for her to be on the show.
You're ruining the listener's request. And now it's completely destroyed.
Quinn.
Great.
Yeah.
So happy my daughter has a theme song.
Quinn.
She doesn't even exist yet.
Nope.
Well, dude, she exists, but she's not here yet.
Dude, she'll be able to listen to this when she's...
I feel bad for her then. She should be listening to something else.
Will you let her
dad.
Listen to this?
Probably not.
Yeah, will you wait till she's older?
Yeah, right. Well, she's 21, maybe in my...
21? Really?
You know, like I'm dead.
I say when she's
16. Listen to it. She can find all these tapes, the lost tapes of Paul and Drew.
It's going to be online.
Oh, well, that sucks.
We don't have physical versions of the show.
We'll have a blackout.
Okay, now, we have this thing called News from the Droosh.
All right, here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, alien mummy found in Atacama Desert and is actually a tiny mutated human. Who knew? So, here's the deal.
Who knew?
They found a 6-inch mummy corpse.
Whoa.
40 years old, 15 years ago, 2003. And they found it, and it has an elongated head.
Wait. It was a 6-inch human?
6-inch human.
That's more than 6 inches, but...
Whatever.
Wait, 6 inches is about...
I mean, usually whenever I look at my dick, it's usually about 7 inches.
That's bogus.
I mean,
you shouldn't be talking about that.
It's usually this big. Is that seven? Okay. It's fine. Anyway, so...
You don't know how to measure things very well.
I don't. Math is just not my specialty. So, here it is. It has a sunken eye socket, elongated skull, and an impossibly tiny body, and it basically looks like the alien from the movie Alien. Right? The elongated head?
Yeah.
You get the reference. Anyway.
Oh, I get it.
It's called Ada. I don't know why. And it is, they finally did a genetic testing on it, and guess what? It's not an alien.
It's a person.
It's a person. Oh. Or just a mutated baby.
Do you have a
baby.
Picture of this?
No, I do not. I'm not on me.
What a journalist.
It's whatever. And so, you know, everybody kind of thought, they thought The Hobbit was an alien at one point, but it's just another human species that was found on an island that from like Neanderthal days.
Wait, is it like a short person?
Yeah, it's short and they actually have big feet. That was why they were called The Hobbit.
Oh.
So fun little fact for you on that one. So this thing's just called Ada.
You know what they say about big feet, right? Big shoes.
Hairy feet. Hilarious.
Hairy feet.
So, and everybody thinks that this thing was ancient, but in reality, it's just 40 years old. So, I don't know. Somebody chucked their mutated baby into the desert or something in Chile and was like, I don't want this baby. That's pretty much what happened there.
What a shame. You know? Why do they gotta be racist towards the little baby?
I don't know. Why can't you just have an alien baby and just call it a day?
Huh. Miss Assistant, will you grab
so,
the
phone?
Thank you.
Anyway, that's my news of the Droosh there, and that was the lamest one I've ever done.
I think that was my favorite segment
but
you've
ever
done.
But I'm not
going to
lie, there
Never
was a
mind.
Lot that happened
I'll
today. The whole, you know, Trump calling Putin and saying, hey, congrats on your election, even though it's a debauchery, you know. But I decided to keep it light today and talk about aliens, because X-Files ended. So, fun times. What are you looking at? What is that?
Excuse me, Mr. Journalist. I come prepared with my news.
Oh, good for you, buddy boy.
Here is the title. Silicon Valley creator says TJ Miller is no LeBron James.
Hmm. Shocker.
Michael Judge and Alec Berg, the creators of HBO's hit comedy series Silicon Valley, spoke to Hollywood Reporter about the upcoming season of the series. Berg told THR that TJ Miller is no LeBron James, and Judge hinted that the many of the cast and crew had been glad to see him go. So I guess people don't like TJ Miller.
That's a shame. I really liked him. That's the reason why I watched the show.
There are a lot of different ways you can find out somebody doesn't want to do the show anymore. And it's not fun to work with someone who doesn't want to be there.
I didn't realize he was, like, I didn't realize he hated it that
Dude,
much.
Dude, he's in China getting high on opium. I mean,
Oh, yeah, his character is, isn't he?
He's still there.
Yeah.
He's in Deadpool.
He is in Deadpool. He's a lot skinnier now.
Yeah. I mean,
he's really thinned out.
Honestly, the reason why I watch the show is him and Jin Yang. I love their little interactions.
Jin Yang.
Yeah. Get out of here, Jin Yang. You know, just those little, hey, you're fat, Uruk. You know, stuff like that. You're fat.
No, I think it's a good time for him to go. He's too much.
Or like, this is your mama. You're not my baby. we make jokes. It's fun. Anyway, so, yeah.
That's kind of upsetting that he's gone. I mean, I like this character, but he's almost a little bit too much.
Why? What makes you say that?
He reminds me too much of you.
Then guess what?
Good to see him go.
Me and that guy have got a lot of explaining to do. But I am as big as LeBron James. I am the man. The Droosh.
Yeah, try again.
And nobody likes the Droosh anyway. Okay.
Hey, Jack.
Yes.
You forgot this.
Welcome back to the studio. Welcome back to the man cave. Nice to have you.
We are proud to announce the Week Review Listener Commercial Challenge. We are asking listeners to submit their own 60-second audio comedy commercial.
Anyone with a computer can make one.
Well, that's it.
We're anyone.
It will run for the next 2 weeks on KCTK Radio.
Just so you know, you have a compliment from KCTK Radio.
The very best entry will receive a $25 gift certificate and the naming right of Drew's son, as well as being in the commercial rotation in future podcasts. Submissions will be reviewed for comedy, creativity, laughability, and whether they're worth a heck.
You're basic.
So you think you're the best? Prove it by submitting your own comedy commercial to kctkradio@gmail.com or call 913-735-0060 if you need more information.
If my answers frighten you, Vincent, then you should cease asking scary questions.
Time for you to be a big winner.
Sure. In my heart, I know I'm funny.
Thank you, Lieutenant.
So, what is the gift card? How much is that?
Exactly.
Right.
Yeah, that's right.
So, right. I've gone through a lot. Lately, I haven't been able to sleep because all I keep picturing in my head is these commercials.
Honestly, truth be told, I've gotten like 3 submissions over the past week.
Well,
I have about 100,000, but it's just, I have 100,000. But over the past week, I've only gotten 3. So I think everyone who I was actually dedicated to the contest is actually already submitted. So we're going to have to go. Oh, we have a caller.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boy.
Hello, caller.
Hi. What caller am I?
You are caller number 6.
Excellent. Is that the one who gets to name the new baby?
Yes, that's right.
Oh, that's right. That's right.
That's too loud.
I'm going to pick Dudley.
Okay. Dudley, you have a middle name as well?
Yes.
Okay.
What is it? What's the middle name?
Middle name?
Yes, Keith, we're wondering. What is the middle name you're going to pick?
I think you should name it Dwayne.
No, you can't use that word.
Oh, we can't do Dwayne? Okay.
No, Dwayne's a dumb one.
Okay, so Keith, here's what we're going to do. For all the content, all the advertisements that we pick, we're going to put them on a giant Wheel of Fortune spinning thing. And then we'll end up being able to pick which one. Like, that is the way we will determine the name. Since you're our 6th caller every single time, you get 2 spots on that wheel.
Only 2?
Only 2.
Only 2.
There's 14 spots on the wheel, and you get 2 of them. Double the chance for you to win. Be a big winner.
He's going to win. Big winner.
Be a big winner. Are you excited for Drew's son?
Yes, because I know it's a girl, but that's okay. They have an operation.
Well, don't worry. Anytime. It's exactly. My child will be able to choose what gender she decides to be. You know? If she doesn't want to be a girl, she can be a dude and change her name to Dudley.
Dudley, exactly.
Perfect.
Yes. That would work.
All right. Well, thank you, Keith.
Thank you for calling, Keith.
And we'll be sure to put you on the Wheel of Fortune to be a big winner.
Okay.
Are you all right there? Are you having a stroke?
Do you have a second to eat? Holy mother forking short balls.
You're a fun one.
I know. It's going to
so
be
this
great.
Has been probably the best show we've probably ever done.
That's my
without
line.
Paul.
Holy
Motherforking shirt balls.
I love that so much. It's so good.
I thought you hated The Good Place.
Yeah. Okay. I want to thank everybody who listened in live today for listening. Remember, this will be on YouTube and on everywhere that you can get your favorite podcasts. Kermit, do you have any final words?
I'd like to thank everybody for listening. Who's listening?
Drew? Thank you. Everybody, please have a fantastic week.
And make sure you spay and neuter your pets and everything like that.
Has been a KCTK production, produced by Paul Lavoda. If you want more information about this content, then you have some real weirdness going on. You can always check out KCTK Radio on Facebook. Listen to live programs at kctk.radio12345.com. Yes, and that is on the World Wide Web. Thank you.